Hello and welcome back to XCOM 2, War of the Chosen. This time, Syken here with a Saving Your Disaster campaign. We're playing Long War of the Chosen. This is a Redditor Saving Your Disaster campaign, and I have been asked to take a look at it because the guy couldn't beat the mission no matter how many times he tried. So to give you a short update about what we're dealing with, we have a mid-November campaign that, instead of using plasma weapons, is still using magnetic weapons, that instead of using plated armor is still using predator armor, and in some cases not even that. So it's not looking great. We are far, far behind the tech tree. On top of that, the soldiers are not really experienced. The guys only focused on 2 squads instead of 5 to 10. So the list of mistakes in the campaign is probably pretty long, which is why I'm not going to go through all of them in detail. However, that being said, I will give my very best to start and win this campaign. I failed to record from the beginning, so let me just fill you in. Basically moved our grenadier, technician rather, here, and started the pack, the first pack, with a rocket, and that's all that happened so far. Let me do the cast of characters real quick. We got Turbo as our specialist, we got a sniper called Showtime, we got Duchess, the Spark, we got a psi operative called Voodoo, we got a an assault called Prophet. We got a ranger called Mustang. We got Sunny, who is going to be our Templar. We got Ripper, the skirmisher. And last but certainly not least, Shield Maiden, who is going to be our technician to shred as much as we can. And we've tried to do that. The enemies are hardcore, so and that is probably even an understatement. The campaign has evolved quite a bit, shall we say. So we got to make sure that we're really doing the best that we can in order to win. Let's start with shredding them as much as possible. So in order to do that, we're using Phase Walk, which is a psi ability in Long War of the Chosen that kind of lets you teleport, and we're continuing to just shred these guys as if there would be no tomorrow. Hopefully the car explodes, and hopefully we're going to get some extra damage and shredding out of it. Not an explosion, not yet. Okay, well, how do we deal with it not exploding? That was not according to plan. Let me think about it. We got a bit of an issue here. I would definitely want the car to explode, because that'll automatically kill these two. Which kind of leaves me to double down almost when we're moving in with our mech. I think we're not going to overdrive yet. We can use that next turn when we're standing still and steady. Should just barely explode the car, hopefully. There we go. Good. That was a lot of shredding. He went down from 5 to 2 points of armor. You can already see we're dealing with just incredibly busted enemies. We the amount of damage that we will need to do in order to even get through their defenses is pretty much. So I want to deal with the boss over here. And I also would love to have one of these super heavy mechs under my control. It's probably not going to happen, to be honest. Let's try to just shut it down. The reason why I'm not going for control is there might be another pack back there. And as good as it is to have a super heavy mech, doesn't do you any good if you're being overrun. That is unfortunate. Just not enough time to move in. Good, moving up. Let's continue with that super heavy mech. 80% shot missed. Ooh, that is unfortunate.
Let's move already.
I don't want to use run and gun yet.
Armor still holding.
Realistically speaking, try to get that Vanguard . The Advent General is too tough to kill him in one turn. Let's use our towers. 25% chance to hit. That is not worth it. Damage control is a big no-no. Just don't want to deal with that. 50-50 on the Advent back there. Advent Vanguard. Kind of a shock trooper that can rupture and really hits hard on single target attacks. Still 50-50 against the guy. Hate to do that and kind of leave the 80% shots open, but damage control just makes it so unattractive to even entertain the idea of shooting at them. Come on, kill this guy. Couple of grazing shots, he's still not dead. Sixty percent to throw the knife. I think that's good enough. There we go. Moving up, and I would do one for all, which allows everybody here to take less damage. At the same time, we're moving kind of into a flanking position. Yeah, I could pull myself towards that guy. Probably not a great idea. Can also use a flashbang grenade just to keep the Advent General busy. ...25% chance to hit him. Not good. But what we could do is we could teamwork over. And just clear the battlefield a tiny bit more. Fuse in order to just let him explode and hopefully also take some cover away. Ooh, nice. We got another option here. Well, if you ask me how I would like to deal with it, let's maybe just take a shot. 65% is not too bad.
I think I got a piece.
It's not fantastic, but it's okay.
We've got the chosen right where we want them. It's time to strike.
So many choices.
All right, Brittle and Adversary versus Reaper. So definitely we gotta go get close and hit with the Reaper. Poisoning enemies, doesn't matter. We do have hazmat vests. I equipped them. The guy didn't have them, so I needed to build them. Extremely strong item in Long War of the Chosen, so you should definitely go for it. Extra damage when flanked, extra aim, extra bonus, marking, and extra aim and critical when low on hit points. So yeah, you don't want to fight him in the open is kind of the short of it. Problem with the Long War of the Chosen is that the Chosens are incredibly strong. So they make your life, they themselves make your life a living nightmare. And it certainly doesn't help that half of our team has a fear of the Chosen.
Eventually, we just have to give them enough time to recover properly.
It's one of the Chosen. This mission just got a little more dangerous. Stay on top of its position and try to take it out.
We got some damage, but most of it was essentially absorbed. And the commander just went somewhere else, which is fine, I guess. I hear chrysalids. That's definitely not fine. Ooh. Let's hope we're not having chrysalids here. Or even worse, like the advanced chrysalids or the chrysalid queen. Very good. Okay, well, that's a good first round. All right, so what are we going to do? Gotta kill all those three guys and somehow deal with the Chosen who landed over there. So let's do that in order, shall we? First things first, we would want to get up here and shred the Advent General. Okay, work out well. Now, let's try to kill said Advent General. One and two. Alrighty. And three.
Looks
and moving over. Okay, that's not a kill. We're going to get one soon.
Tired of waiting around.
Let's move over. Hit this guy, hit him very well. 14, that is fantastic. and let's finish it, plus gain a knife back. Thanks to Silent Killer, we're not being revealed, and we should have 5 knives now. Yep, got 5 knives again. That's good. Okay, so let's continue to deal with the Advent Officer. Fantastic, that's another kill. And let us hit the mech. Okay, so far so good. We could pick up some loot there. If we do have time, I'll do it. I'll be careful not to waste movement, because we really need to get to the Chosen. Alright, moving over here. And
seems doable.
Moving over here. He still has damage control. How is that even a thing? Alright, luckily the towers help us quite a bit. But we're moving up. And I would say we're mind merging with a sniper, but that actually requires us to see the sniper, so let's move over here. Mind merge with the sniper. I'm still having the slight hope that we might be able to hit the Chosen. Mind merge would help us dealing quite a bit more damage and also being protected against his retaliation. I was hoping we would be able to see him.
Roger that.
All right, moving up.
So it is decided.
But we're going to steady the weapon instead. Not the worst turn.
Let's make this clear.
Why exactly can he see us and we can't see him? Well, normally the explanation would be because there's kind of a hidden chrysalid, but I wouldn't be surprised if the Hunter Chosen just has perfect vision. All across the map. Well, that was disheartening. So, what to do? You know the Chosen is there. Try to get a better look. Two more rounds until we can restill, but we could change that with manual override. Alright, stealthing again.
As you ordered, moving up. Commander. I spotted an alien patrol.
Oh, wow. Oh,
this
wow.
This one is uniquely graceful compared to some of the other species we've seen. It also gives off very strong psionic readings.
Okay, let's start with hitting the Chosen. Unfortunately, it cannot be crit because it's minus 200% chance to be crit. But Deadeye still deals quite a bit of damage and ignores, and thanks to AP rounds, we're ignoring his armor. Moving up here. I would love to just shred him. Even if the use of another rocket seems excessive. Overall, him being kind of in that bad spot actually helps us quite a bit. Alright, so how can we mark him, or at least make it so that we're hitting him better? Let's use this crippling strike throw.
I take responsibility.
That's a miss.
I blame it on bad leadership.
Still throwing. 70% is already the best we can get against him. Could move all the way up here, but we would not really be able to hit him. Let's start with the towers. 40% is not great. But somehow we're hitting those. The only thing that we need to make sure is we cannot pull another pack. Everything else is fair game, just do not pull another pack. Good.
I call upon the earth itself.
Full cover right there. And we're moving over here, and we'll be going one fall just to provide even more cover. Okay, let's shortly double check if I was standing here. Would I be able to see him? No, I would not. Good, so potentially we need to be here. Well, not even that is allowing us to see him. That's unfortunate.
On your order.
Okay, Good. Face walking over. Which kind of ends the turn, but what we can do is the following. We're giving an aid protocol our sniper. Because we really don't want him to be hurt. And we're giving an extra action via command to Voodoo, because Soul Bolt is potentially one of our best options at this point. It's essentially secure damage against him.
I'm inside your head.
And any form of secure damage really is needed at this point. Moving up into full cover. And our mech moves into cover as well.
Good to go.
We're really switching sides and are really balancing all of our team towards the right hand side. Nope, we're not going to pull anyone else. It is essentially turnover.
Alright, team. Let's get this done. It's gonna be quick. I'll fire a few inches.
Oh boy.
This is my specialty.
Just lost a heavy turret. That's unfortunate. Not triggered yet, right? Right. It is triggered.
I'm not sure what the elders expect me to do.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Projects.
Christmas. Why does it always need to be a Christmas? Good. Well, we gotta deal with this here. Somehow. Let's start with insanity.
Can you hear me?
It doesn't end our turn. Shot, unfortunately missed. Okay, well, that's too bad. What are we going to do about the Chosen? That's the more important question. Are we going to 50-50? We need to take care of those chrysalids, so let's start with the obvious ones. These turrets here can't hit the Chosen, so might as well go for the chrysalids. Right? Right. Okay. That's one down.
Don't get so excited.
Thousands to go.
Those guys are a dime a dozen.
An easy advent trooper. I'm going to fall for that. Well, maybe we are falling for that because it's the only thing that we can actually hit. Good, let's start with the big boy. It's time to light him up.
Oh,
still hit. Guy's almost down. Overdriving. Our mech continues to stay here. Chrysalid is down. Let's hit the other chrysalid.
Optical system recalibrating.
Come on. Okay. That's good. Hit, but not 100% kill. We can hit this guy. Very nice, he's bleeding. And we need to get out of reach because our cover will soon be gone. Our concealment, rather. This here could be a kill against the Chosen. Come on.
Target's still up.
So close. Don't have Soulfire ready yet. Alright, Hunter. Miss. Another Hunter, come on. 50-50, two misses. Can't leave them up in the open like that.
Repositioning.
Open up. Taking that high ground advantage that we need. 45% to hit him. Let's go for the crystal first. Not good enough. This here is not triggering anything. Flamethrower is just a little bit too short. How disappointing. Down to 3 hit points. We could go in, but that would trigger the entire pack, and it's not worth it. Next round we can kill him for sure with Soulfire. Good, not good. Come on, Syken, you need an idea. Moving over into full cover. It's just a 20% chance to hit. Not good enough. Chrysalid is also a problem, we gotta deal with that guy. Alright, Chrysalid down.
Moving as ordered.
Okay, so what's the deal? Can't hit anything. Might as well just do the one for all thing again. 0%. Chances wouldn't be much better. 26% is as good as it gets, I think. Nice. Wow, that is a huge relief, being able to kill him.
You surprised me once again, Commander.
Well, F you, buddy.
Maybe I need to reconsider my tactics.
Excellent work, Commander. We may not have put them down for good, but at the very least, we've held off the Chosen for another day.
Okay, so this is tough luck. Let's try to stun him 50-50. Oh, perfect. Good. We even have that under control. That went so well. I had a backup plan because there's an advanced teamwork and I could have had another shot at 30%. But that last hit was actually quite lucky.
We can no longer hide.
Ooh, very good. Okay, cool. That is pretty much the natural end of part one of the Saving Your Disaster campaign. It is looking still very dire. We got a gatekeeper here. We got potentially another pack here. And we got to deal with the fallout of that pack. So there are quite a few enemies left, if not even more down the road. We're not even halfway in the map and we have had so much resistance, like a pack of 10, then the Chosen on top of it, another pack of 8 that we needed to deal with, and all of that with these BB guns. We've lost one tower, which I think is fine considering the circumstances, but we have a pretty nice clustered up pack of soldiers. And that high ground here, at least for the sniper, will go a long way. So that's an actual breaking point, guys. We're going to see each other in the next episode 2 days from now. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy the content and like these types of videos, don't forget to leave a comment and a like down below. That helps the algorithm. You're enjoying the entertainment for free. Might as well give something back in return and like it. Thank you and have a great one. Bye-bye.